kabiyesi o kabiyesi
Bashomi,
I have the distinguished honor and privilege of having a conversation this evening with one of Africa's most cerebral monarchs. When you talk about a king who knows his onions, he was a teacher, a lawyer, an administrator. He's worked in the National Assembly. He has traversed the length and breadth of the world. He is very special to me and my family. He gave me my biggest title of Bashong. Seeing you from here, you won't believe it. I just shed tears. I'm very emotional because I know how far we have come. KBC, kindly introduce yourself to this global viewership. It's incredible. People are watching you from everywhere, KBC.
Bashong, I thank you. This is Dalai Lua Oba Adedokunmo Moniya Bolarin, Aroyinka the First, the Onogun of Okeila Onogun. I tell people all the time, I didn't go to school to be a king. Destiny. Ibi tori ba dani si ibe lagbe. I was born and bred in Ibadan. Few years before independence, to be specific, 1958. My father was a primary school headmaster, a community leader.
We need you a bit louder, sir. We need you louder. People want to pick every word, sir.
Maybe yes, I'll start all over again.
Closer to you, sir.
I'll start all over again.
Okay, sir.
Can you hear me?
Yeah. I'm hearing
you. Can you hear me?
We can make it louder. It will be fantastic.
Yes, I'll try. Oba Adedokun Abolarin. Aroyinka the First is my name. I say it on set. I didn't go to school to be a king. I'm the Onogun of Okeila Onogun. But Ibitori ba dani si ibe lagbe, fate and your mom, destiny. And we thank God. I was born early in life because of my background. As a small boy, I saw the turbulence in the Western region. I started going to school in 1964, Seventh Day Adventist Primary School, Agodi Ibadan, where my father, may his soul rest in perfect peace, was my primary school headmaster. All his children attended his school. That is to tell you the level of the primary school that I attended, where my father was headmaster. I finished in 1969 and I went to Adventist Grammar School Ede between 1970 and 1974, the end of the Civil War, 1970. And from there, I proceeded to Ibadan Polytechnic for my A-levels. Then I went to that great university, the great University Ife. Of Ife. From 1976 to 1980, I read political science there. Well-grounded. When I say well-grounded, I thank the Lord Almighty. I did my youth service in the serene, peaceful part of Nigeria, Plateau State, just to be specific, Nigerian Police Staff College, 1980-81. Thereafter, started life entirely. Returned to the University of Ife for my master's degree, and at the same time, I started to work in the then Oyo State College of Arts and Science, Ile Ife, OSCARS. I was there for a very long time. I was there for about 10 years. And I didn't know that that was a preparatory grant for my enthronement as a king. Later, I went back to school. I read law. After my master's degree, because I have passion for education. And to the glory of God, I think, I have a feel of education. Then life, taught for very many years, ended my career in the then St. Andrew's College of Education, Oyo. For my law school, 1991, I was called. I practiced law in Lagos with my friend, my charming friend, S.C. Onodele, Femi Onodele, and co. Before I started my there, I was into everything. When I say I was into everything, I was a political activist. The number one magazine then in Nigeria, Tell Magazine, some other companies. I was active. I was politically active. But again, by 2000, I moved to Abuja. I became the special advisor to the then Senate president. I impiled time on legal matters. And 2003, started to practice law. I wanted then to be the foremost lawyer lobbyist in Nigeria. I was on the right track, starting to do very well. And the clarion call came suddenly in 2006 for me to be the Orogun in Okeola Orogun. It was sudden. I didn't expect it. I wanted to reject it. But in Abuja, I consulted widely. May the souls of some of these people that I consulted then continue to rest in perfect peace. Senator Macedo, unforgettable in my life. He had a plane crash, the same plane with his preeminent, the Sultan of Sokoto, Sultan Macedo. He advised me, he told me, because I told him, I said, no, I wasn't interested to be a king. I said, my place is being. He said, that is why you should go there. I said, it's a powerful throne, but small place. He said, that is why you must go there. And to other great Nigerians, unforgettable, Mrs. Toyi Duarte, she was my lecturer at the Nigerian Law School. He taught me criminal procedure. But in Abuja, for about 2 years, we became very close. She told me that, Dokun, you must heed the call. And that great man, Professor Sal, the former vice chancellor of Ahmadu Bello University, wherever he is, may the good Lord continue to bless his soul. I can't forget. I told him, I said, majority of my people are eager for me to be on the throne. And I said, I'm still waiting for God's voice. He said, Dokun, have you forgotten that the voice of the people is the voice of God, Vox Populi, Vox Dei? So what are you waiting for again? So, Ajimobi, this was dramatic. He said, Dokun, why must you be a king? I said, you are in Abuja here, you are doing well for you to be a king. He said, majority said no. Then immediately said, wow, Dokun, you can't refuse this thing. There's this crown on your head, though, and you must take it, and it's glorious. You cannot afford to take it. You must take it. Wow. That some other people, some very many of my friends didn't like, but thank God for people like Bashir. He said, Ebon, Jekin, go there and take it immediately. I know you. You are likely to change the institution. How can I change the institution now? An archaic institution. An institution that people think is anachronistic. But to the glory of God, the institution that I now am now in is a major institution for the development of our people. You are still Ashtashe Ikeji Orisha in equity, though not in law, because Section 11 of the 1999 Constitution expressly states that You know, this constitution is supreme. But our people still believe in the institution. And that is history. I became a king in 2006, almost 40 years ago. And wow, the best thing that has ever happened to me is my becoming the Onogun of Okeila here. I thank God the Lord Almighty. And I thank God all my friends. Bashorun, I thank you. There's some people that I cannot mention their names. You know, a friend of mine called me this evening. He said he had to call me just to congratulate me on the little that I'm doing. Because when I was about to be enthroned, he told a lot of people that what's wrong with him. Is he crazy? What does he want to go and do there? But service is service. You don't run away from service. Give me a platform, just like the essay, the first essay written by Anthony Nauru at age 21 as editor of the Southern Defender in Warri. Give me a platform and I'm going to change the world. Bashorun, I thank you. You have a platform innovation and you are trying to change the world. All of us, we all have our platforms. We can change the world. We can change Nigeria. I beg all of us, we should not lose it. Nation building is a process. It is not a thing we get done overnight. To be a king, with due respect, I always think being a king was beneath me. But service to one's motherland is the greatest thing ever. So in a nutshell, that is who I am.
Kabiezi, as I watch you speak those powerful words, penetrating words, I'm wondering, don't you think, as a political scientist now, that Nigeria must find a way to go back to parliamentary system? And you were close to his family, the Oni of Ife, Oba,
yes,
Adesojita Adeniawo, Aderemi, and you could see that life was a lot better then. I don't know how you want to react to this, sir.
You see, I'm going to use that statement of that great man, Alexander Pope. For all forms of government, let fools contend. For what is best administered is best. Monarchy, if you have great souls on the throne, they turn a monarchical system to be the best government. That is the way I see it. For all forms of government, let fools contend. For what is best administered is best. When I was young, very many Nigerians never liked the parliamentary system of government. Vehemently, it was opposed. Nigerians opposed it. Instability, where what have you, no majority principle at the parliament. When are we going to stop what governance is all about? It saddens me when I look at the statement of Prime Minister Churchill to Roosevelt during the Atlantic Charter. He told Roosevelt that the rate at which independence was being tabled at international fora was not appropriate there. That we were not yet ripe for independence. It saddens me that we do not know what it is to be responsible. Responsibility is key. It's important. You know what it is to be responsible, that people's money is not your money, that the next man must be taken care of, that we should celebrate diversity, that conflict in a democracy is normal, but we should have statements that will move forward and resolve those conflicts, that people's money can never be your money. I'm mean, what do we do? Whether we complain against parliamentary, we complain against presidential, so what are we going to do? Now, I run away from politics anyway, but as a political scientist, I occasionally hear my views. But as a traditional ruler, I totally run away from politics because I'm no longer a partisan. All the gladiators, all the political gladiators are mine. They're my children. The palace is for all of them. We are just praying for Nigeria, but occasionally we talk. We need to prepare our young ones for leadership. But again, we must be conscious of preparing our young ones for leadership. That, I'm not sure, we are doing.
Kadesi.
Yes, please.
We are going too fast, sir. I want to take you back. Because I was privileged to know you at UNIFE. And you were my senior colleague when I was teaching A-level Yoruba at the Oyo State College of Arts and Science between 1982 and 83. And we all looked up to you then. We didn't know we were looking at Obalola. You had a beetle. Your beetle. One thing, again, I must say about you is that you are never in a hurry. Never. I've never seen you in a hurry. Your beetle, tuke, you are going to overtake you around the gire or something. It's like you had a cruise control on your car. And then you like the music. Before you hear come, KBSE was dancing. Until today, I know you are a good dancer. Can you give us the recollection of your days at Ife?
Not and some of my your days
friends and all that.
Yes, one of them you are. Ife, Ibadan Polytechnic, my secondary school days. You know, we thank God that we are Jackie, Amobe, Atidagba, we are old. But while growing up, we had fun. Nigeria was lively. Nigeria was good. If it was good, student fraternity from Ife to UNILAG, UNILAG to UI, UI to UNIBEN, cross country. In Ife, we move from one joint to another. We move from High Muda to Staff Club to wherever. It was all fun. But right now, you see, one is always scared. When one's children now start going everywhere, you're scared. Because the environment is no longer good for things like that. And that is why we need to make things work in Nigeria. There must be peace. You cannot develop in an environment that is not peaceful. We lose a lot. So many things that you can resolve through a round table. We just continue to make the whole environment not conducive for development. Let's go back. And for God's sake, I don't always like laying emphasis on the past. The present will be better than the past. And the future must be better than the present. I have a prepared future. You know? That's why we are doing some of the things that we are doing. What will Nigeria be, or our environment be the next 50 years, the next 60 years, the next 100 years, where we are not going to be part of? So, yes, we had fun while going on. History. What is the state of things today? How can we make today better than yesterday and the future better than today? That's where we are.
KBSE, Can you remember that in those days, all the children of who is who was in Ife? Most yes, universities please. In Nigeria yes. had children. If you ever traveled, maybe you will go for your second or third degrees or you won a scholarship.
Question for all of us. It's a big question. It's saddening. If it was it, Ibadan was it, Unilag was it. But now, all our children are outside of Nigeria. It's really sad. It's really sad.
And do you remember the Ali Davidson boys in Ife?
Of course, yes. Very many of them are listening now. We thank God for their lives. It was a pact. Those of us that didn't have the wherewithal to buy it, the friendship was like beautiful. And we pray that we go back to that era. And for us to do that, all of us, we have that moral obligation to create a better future. I say it just like Theodore Roosevelt. Yes, many critics, few doers. I pray we have many doers and less critic. And the environment itself must be conducive for a viable society.
Yes, I said it already, that I know you love music and you're a great dancer. I want to take you back and take you down memory lane, you know, and give you one of them.
I want to go and do. You want to get down? Tell me. I want to go and do. Do you want to get down? I want to go and do. Do you want to get down? I want to go and do. Do you want to get down? Tell me.
Get down on it. Get down.
Time in the world for you, Kabiyesi. I'll give you one more.
Thank you.
Continue.
But you know the position that I'm in now.
I can see you shaking, Kabiyesi.
Won't allow me to go the old hall.
I know that if we
won't allow me to go the old hall as in those days, but we thank God.
We thank God. We'll give you one more, Kabiyesi, before we continue the conversation. One of your favorites in those days.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. I have one of your daughters online, Buki Ayola, is watching you and very, very proud of you, KBC. A lot of your sons and daughters are here and they are hailing you.
Yeah.
We thank God. We thank God for the life of KBC. Yes, there is no way we can talk about you and not talk about development. You are passionate about development.
Passionate.
And
Nigeria.
We don't have to wait for anybody before we play our part. I remember one of your heroes. He was a king and you loved him so much. Do you remember who I'm talking about? Who built his queen?
Obaoladile Olashiwe.
Olashiwe.
The Owaloko of Iloko.
Yes, sir. Can you tell us about your relationship, sir?
Yeah, when I became the Onogui Inokela, I just gravitated towards him. Not him alone. KBC, the owner of Fife, Obakun Adesiju Ade, and that monarch, reservoir, tradition, a man full of wisdom, the Ogiyan of Ejigo, Oba Omowonu, Oba Omowonu Ola, Oyeyode, Oyeyos. Well, cultured man, regal all the time. You love him as a monarch, full of wisdom. Take, for example, Papa Oyeyode Oyesosi. Thank God for his life. Probably he's watching me now. Said, Baba, if you want to grow old, what do you do? Say, KBC, the one woman told me some time ago that I'm going to sing it in Yoruba. Je, omi ogun ogbo. Ogbo kan ko logun o. Je, ohun logun ogbo. In all that we do. So I was fortunate relating with this great of God on the throne. They trained me. I moved very close to them. But you have to learn. In journalism, you have to learn. In legal practice, you have to learn. As a teacher, you have to learn the rudiments of the profession. And as a traditional ruler, I thank God I learned from these great Nigerians. And even Obatade Nikawo Adereni, may his great soul continue to rest in perfect peace. The Olubadan of Ibadan, Oba Akinyele, the first literate Christian Oba from 1955 to 1964. Then that legend, Oba Adetoyese Lawye, the Timi of Ede, this monarch. And yes, and my Baba, my predecessor in Ilaun, that great monarch, visionary leader, Oba William Adetoyese Ayeni.
William Ayeni.
These are people that ate and chewed development. These were monarchs that believed in that concept of Idagbasoke. And that is what some of us are now trying to do.
Before we go, we are going to come to La Orogun last, because Igunla Lunke Ibale. But I want us to go on tour of Nigeria. I know you had great respect for Chief Obafemi Awolowo. Could you tell us a bit about your admiration for Baba Awolowo?
You know, in a nutshell, when our friend got married, maybe Kemi Maybe I'm telling you, maybe Kemi is hearing this for the first time. Kemi, a friend, granddaughter of Papa Oba, and a friend that Mola Aderemi, when they got married in Ibadan, I purposely moved very close to Chief Obafemi Awolowo. And I shook his hand. And immediately I shook his hand. I just removed my hand and I took it into my pocket. And I left. Few of my friends, notably the present speaker of Ekiti State, Honorable Fumini Afuye, knew that I was going towards Chief Obafemi Awolowo. Because we had mentors. Yeah, because we had mentors in our time. You aspired to be like certain people. My aspiration in life was to be like Chief, and that is what we should try as much as possible to do. Leadership is key. Leadership is important. That's how to build a society. That is Chief Obafemi Awolowo. Who next, please?
Before we leave Chief Awolowo, we can't leave Chief Awolowo without talking about his books that you read. Which one made the most impression and impact on you?
All his books. His autobiography. His autobiography. Autobiography. He wrote one or two before the autobiography in 1966. But there's one aspect as a traditional ruler now that I so much love. When he was a student of Wesley College in Badon, the motto of Wesley College was and it still is, be anything she in Russia. Be any tom she in Russia. Servant leader. And these school children never liked the idea. And their principal then, Nightingale, was always telling them that, please, you people are going to find yourself in position of authority in the foreseeable future. Think local. Believe in yourselves. Be indigenous. Love your culture. Love your tradition. Love your language. Love your food. That was in 1929. How I wish we are taking to this man's advice. Going indigenous to the glory of God. Look at what I'm wearing. Look at what is on me. We have things that are so beautiful, but we do not admire what we have. We don't always admire our own thing. Edewa ujowa loju. Ashowa utewa long. Our food we don't like. And we have to go back to that. If we want to make progress as a people, we have to admire ourselves. We have to know that, hey, we are the best. We are the best. You think of yourself first before going outside. That I love in his autobiography. And so many other things. Part to Nigerian Constitution. Yes, there are three important books that I want Nigerians, our children, to read. It's to be a compulsory text for all our children because they should know where we are coming from. The autobiography of Chief Obafemi Awolowo, My Odyssey by Chief Nnamdi Azikiwe, and My Life by that great man, the Sardana of Sokoto, Sir Ahmadu Bello. The Premier of the North from 1951 until 1966. These are great books. These are great books. I can tell you a lot of things in those books, but time may not permit us to go into presentation of them. Yeah, exactly.
Well, your son, Wale Adeyemo, is watching from North Carolina, USA. He says we should give
so
you
cool.
3 hours.
We
will try our
so
best.
Cool. So cool.
And then I can see the Olayomis. You must be very happy the Olayomis are watching.
They are watching. I'm happy that my people are watching. My brothers and my sisters from Kochi. My mother is Olayomi.
I know. Fantastic. Yes, there Thank was another you. Great man I knew you were close to, the late Chief Bola Ige.
I learned a lot from me.
I'm putting you on the spot tonight.
I learned refuse becoming a king. He was late, but I saw him. Let me tell you in my dreams what he told me. He said, Do okun mo gbo pe o so pe o fe je oba. Is that the kind of training I give to you? You want to stay in Abuja? No, you should go back to where our people want you. Service is service. In my dream, I saw him. And I said, wow. I said, wow. Because he trained us during the crisis. He told us that, hey, if they should pick me, you guys are in charge. Take charge. We learned a lot from him. Is now where the young and the old, they will come together to learn from people instead of jumping the gun. If not because of my relationship with a lot of people, I'm happy that my cousins are watching me.
I'm told the Abolaris worldwide are watching you also. I just received that message.
God bless you all. God bless you. And I guess all my friends are watching California, me.
Sending you their love from California.
I love them too. I thank them.
Yes. You won't believe it. It's almost 1 hour, but we will extend. Don't worry, Kabiesi, we will extend. Now, there is a story that I know touched you seriously. And that was the wedding of our friend and brother, Ladino Laduke Akintola and Oluwatoyin Ige. Yes, could you comment about that day?
That wedding, I always tell Ladino, with due respect, is a judge in Ibadan. And to the glory of God, Toyin is a professor of law in UI. But the two of them were from two opposing political families, the late Chief S.L.A. Akintola and Toyin, the niece of Chief Bola Ige. For students of history, you know, I wasn't clear it was going to be possible. Okay, but you, Damola, you package everything and everything went very well. And to the glory of God, they are now grand.
I remember writing an article that day. I wrote an article.
Oh, yes, you did. Yes, you did. But again, where we are going is that since then, I don't create lifelong enemies, either for political reasons or for economic reasons or traditional. Maybe that's why I flow with people, because we do not know where our children are going to meet. Children of our enemies getting married, and to the glory of God, they're above 30 years in marriage now. They are grandparents. So why must we fight for reasons best known to us? Once you have conflict, a statement, we should try as much as possible to resolve those conflicts. That is the lesson of the relationship that, you know, I imbibed since then. Because opposing camps We saw them during the engagement. They were all saying, wow, we didn't know that this type of this day will ever come in a lifetime. The late Chief Ajigun of Ogbomoso, late Chief Tinubu from Iresi, all of them were there. And I learned a serious lesson there. And Dele, you wrote a beautiful piece that time.
Thank you, sir.
Never must we hold on to serious.
It was a great day in Ibadan. It was a great day in
Ibadan. Yeah, we thank the Lord Almighty.
Both of them are doing very well. Their children are doing very well.
We thank God.
I still have more. We're not going anywhere, Kabiyesi. I still have more. And
you're putting me on the ball
of your relationship. Yes, I'm taking advantage now that I know you too well, Kabiyesi. I knew of your relationship with the Olubuse Ereo Ogun Ebiti Kimopiri Osumonle Sumeni Olubuse Alakete Ogun Dakunda Boma Kamilogun Jenkuti Kami.
Great
Baba
man.
Baba traveled all the way to Okela. Despite the distance, the rough.
Because, you know, traditionally, there's a relationship. But beyond that, he was fond of me. And white. As small as I was to eat there, if I tell Papa not to do, I'm saying it for the first time ever, publicly. If I tell Papa not to do certain things, Papa will just look at me and say, what do you think so? And I have many that Papa had to sheath the sword. And beyond that, Baba was a compendium of wisdom. Papa was a compendium of history. Papa was a diplomat par excellence. Papa had a good relationship with Chief Obafemi Awolowo, and at the same time, he had a good relationship with Chief Eseli Akintola. And I told him, the powers that be. In fact, there was a time we had to visit the late Chief AME Akinwunmi towards the tail end of his life. The Chief AME Akinwunmi was on his way out. But immediately he saw Papa, they had their slant. And they remember those good old days. They started whistling. I said, wow. He said, we had our own good time too. You know? And Papa, one thing. We were, okay, you're trying to.
I served Kabiyesi Oni in 1986.
You did. And by 2:30 a.m., he called for me. I said, Baba, I left you around 12 midnight. By 2:30, you are calling me. Why? He said, Enitoba Mowono Kinsun. I internalized that. I picked that from E. Don't forget, I told you, I picked something from Ogiyon, so also, Baba, so many things that, you know, relationships, you know, get to a lot of things, wisdom, knowledge. Then it's important for our young ones to move with elders. They learn a lot.
Kabiyesi, I will still ask you about a few more people, but we will have a break with music. If it cuts off, then we will reboot and start again. Because definitely we cannot, it's exactly 1 hour since we started, but we cannot end you 1 hour. So,
okay.
We all have pain, we all have sorrow.
Thank you. I mean, so continue to rest in perfect peace.
Ah, Buki Ayola says, we all need someone to lean on. I agree with you. This was my favorite song in Ife. You know, that poor little boy. Anytime I was feeling sorrowful and sad, and I would say, God, I need someone to lean on. God, please send me my helper. And God sent so many of them. So many. Beginning with Damola Aderemi. I'm not sure if he's watching, but I told him he has to watch our KBC this evening. If he's not watching, I'll send him the tapes. He's been extremely busy of late. You know, he's our brain box. We used to think Damola was older than all of us in those days because his brain was just exceptional. Much younger than you. I think Damola was your teacher as well.
He was my teacher. He taught me contract.
Oh, contract.
Yes, he taught me contract and commercial law.
Wow.
Yeah, Damola taught me. Sorry for calling him Damola anyway. Yes, he was my classmate. He was my classmate initially. You know, we finished in 1980, but eventually he taught me contract and he taught me commercial law. Brilliant guy. Brilliant.
We had our Road 9 clique that were your younger brother. When we were all living with my older brother, Professor Dele Ajayi.
Yes, I'm not sure you still remember 1987. Our business escapade in Ede.
Please talk about our escapade. That was one of our worst experiences in life.
1987, when we lost everything.
We lost all our investments.
And we lost all our investment, but we tried.
Hmm.
We made the move.
Hmm.
Good experience. But we all love ourselves then. In India, 1987, NYSC camp. NYSC. We wanted to make a key. Yeah, we wanted to make a key. We invested, we thought, yes, 2+2 was going to give us 4. Not knowing that business is not like that. We lost everything. And Professor Ajayi, your brother, said,
I borrowed money from you,
your investment from him. Yes, you borrowed your investment from him. And it was impossible for you to pay back. And Bradley said, Dele, you must be crazy. You can't lose your money and lose. Let's stop there. But that was a good experience.
I know what you are saying, sir.
Yeah, that was
my dividend was a padlock. The padlock, you know, we had to share our dividends. I remember I sold ice cream on my head. I had ice cream because
big deal.
Our deep freezer packed up suddenly.
Packed up, and we didn't know that. The deep freezer had packed up.
It had packed up, and the
we didn't know.
I had to carry it on.
How about the film? Ben, how about the films? How about the films that did?
We brought the tape, cut, bam, and people started asking for their money back. Oh my God.
But a lot of these things, most of our children who know that we expect all these things. Yes. You know? Good experience.
We suffered. We suffered.
Yeah, we thank God.
And then our potato and chicken, we were selling chicken and chips. And then the day we started, rain fell heavily and our place was waterlogged. And we lost the potatoes.
We lost everything.
Then one day I slept next to the freezer. I would have died.
Yes, exactly. This is why you see. This is why I always tell people. This is why I always tell it is important for us to go back to the study of history. It is important for us to go back to the study of history. History to some people is complex, but history is the best humorist. Can you imagine the sad experience that we had then, to the glory of God, is now found today.
Wow. that was an experience.
Yeah,
okay, I was going to ask you about traditional rulers, one of them again. Okay, two more. The
yes, please.
Iku Babayeye Alashe Ekeje Orisha Oba Lamidi Olayiwola Adeyemi the Third Shagiri Lagiri Olagiri Kakafi Gbedubo.
Kabesi, I'm very fond of him. I'm fond of him because he's deep. And he does not joke in anything intellectualism, even at his age. If you send any memo to him, if you send any good book to him, within a week, he will tell you everything about the book. In fact, I read Estos Kabesi only yesterday about his book on Anila Omowura. I said, I was shocked to see that Papa has read the book from the first page to the last page at his age. Let's give that to Kabir.
Oh.
Very fond of him. And again, he's a king, he's a monarch that is satoric. He has the way his dress pattern. Beautiful, colorful. His deep knowledge of the Yoruba language, I think, is outside his world. Great man, great monarch. May the good Lord continue to bless him and expand him.
Yes, we're still going with Kabiyesi. Tonight is the night. It's a day. It's a night of sweet memories, sweet and sour memories. You know, as I talk to you, I have tears all over my eyes. It's incredible. I want us to talk about that great scholar, the great mathematician, Dr. Victor Omololu Sewabimo Oluloyo.
That's another man entirely. I think we should just clone his. We should just clone his brain. we should just clone his head. He's an all-rounder.
Wow.
He's an all-rounder. And we thank God that his son, Benga Omololu Oluloyo, is very, very close to us. Kapo here, kapo there. Kapo here, kapo there. It was
Kapo
Papa that said that.
Me in London during my exile days for months. Kapo and Ayo.
I know.
I will never forget them.
I know.
I will never.
Kabiyesi, I mean, Papa Molulu lawyer, thank God for his life. Brilliant man. And these are people that we need to learn from. The upcoming and the aged. But there's one thing that we are missing in Nigeria. For us to say that Usiagu fun election, no? Once you are no longer in government, in power, people forget you. It is wrong. It is not right. It is important for us to tap from the wealth of experience of our elders. It's key. It's key. You know, it's important.
Wow. Now, I know that, yes, my wife just sent me a note that I should not forget that you cajoled her into marrying me because people told her I was too poor to marry the daughter of the first Attorney General of Ogun State, Chief Akinola Adaramaja. And you had to do pep talk. Even till now, if we have quarrels, you are the only person who can call her and talk to her. Thank you, Kabiyesi. She has mandated thank me you. To thank you publicly.
Bolaji, I thank you. Do we, you know, let's hear what we cooked before she agreed going out with you. You should tell the whole world, Dele. What did I tell her? You know, because of who you were at that time, Bolaji was scared. And I told Bolaji, Bolaji, don't worry. You know, Dele is my friend. Just give him, just try him for a week. If you are certain that within the week you are not okay, you can abandon him. But to the glory of God, the 1 week turned to 2 weeks. The 2 weeks turned to 4 weeks. The 4 weeks turned to 1 year. The 1 year turned to eternity.
He's watching you and sending message. Kabiyesi, Blajo 10.
You what?
He's watching.
You what?
Blajo is watching you. She just sent
Kabiyesi. Okay. Okay. Blajo, my Blajo.
And Bukie who started it all. He's also watching.
We thank you. Bukie. God bless you. How is daddy, that great man? Honorable Justice Ayola, retired Justice of the Supreme Court. We thank God for his life.
Great man. Bolaji said she's laughing seriously. Bolaji and Kabiyesi, you can never know how close the two are. Okay, we're getting there. I think one of your best friends today is also a king. I see you wear the same kind of dresses and so on. Timi Agbale Olofana.
Yes, I schooled in Ede. I went to Adventist Grammar School Ede. And to the glory of God, I met great people in Ede. And Adetoye Shelawye as a small boy. So automatically, I had to extend my relationship, my hand of fellowship to Kabiyesi Timi. Laminisa, the first great man, cerebral, passionate about development, you know, good man, deep, is just an act of God, not any other thing, it's just an act of God. And you know, I'm very, very close to the other people. And I know that you all know that Dr. Adedeji Adeleke.
I was coming today. there's no way anybody can talk about Kabiyesi and not talk about Dr. Adedeji Adeleke Baba Olowo You know, every time what Kabi Esi tells all of us is wherever you see Dr. Adedeji Adeleke, please thank him. I mean, your sense of gratitude is amazing, Kabi Esi. Please.
Hello. Hello.
I can hear you, sir.
Yes. You know Deji, popularly known as Chairman, we were in school together. I can write a whole book on him. Kind-hearted. When I say kind-hearted, gifted, is from a political family. His father was Balogun of Ede, and his father was a former senator in the Federal Republic of Nigeria between 1979 and the year 2003. You can go through the Hansards. You see his works well written in the Hansards. But beyond that, we became friends since 1971. And to the glory of God, he has been so kind to me. I leaned on him. Not him alone. I have many like you. I can start to mention names, but I know that some of you won't just want me to mention. Is it Femi Onodele, the speaker?
I hear the Onodeles are watching you tonight, Kabiyesi.
Wow, they must watch me. Ledo, God bless you. Is it Jibola, Mashujoba, or Gwega, Okegbenro? A lot of you. Jide will be a king. Very many of my friends didn't want me, and Jide was one of them. Jide talked to almost all our friends. He said, tell Dogzi that we are going to give the chief maker, the king maker, money. They should leave me alone. And I told him that, hey, I had no choice. And I must always show gratitude to him because Jide Oweye gave 17 of my children from Okela here scholarship in Lipsity University.
Wow.
One of them is a lecturer today, pursuing his PhD. You know, another one pursuing his PhD in Ibadan. That is the essence of education. Professor Jide Oweye, thank you. And very many of my friends, there are too many to be mentioned. At the appropriate time, we are going to document all these things.
I know you like to talk fondly about the Adeleke University. Could you tell us, please, why you love the university so much?
Adeleke University. Where? Which university?
Adeleke University in Ede.
Oh, Adeleke, please go there. You think you are in the United States of America? Well planned, beautiful university. Well built. And I pray that all our rich men in Nigeria are going to do things like that. And half of the students in that university, they are on the scholarship of the proprietor. Please check, find out. And I always tell people that if you are Deji's friend and you are not kind, you're not taking anything from him.
Wonderful, wonderful. Before we continue, Orlando Owo Logba Logba.
I'm not going to be able to do it. lórí ọ̀pọ̀ ìràn láti dáẹ̀ lọ́dá ohun tó ti dá sí dáadáa ṣé kúkú ẹ. Bọ́bọ̀ lálẹ́ ọmọ aláìní lójú, kákò má ṣe fi àwọn ọmọ aláìní bàbá.
Kabiesio, I think.
Thank you, Basho. I love that. Deep is for all of us. That we are here for just a while. We are here for just a while. Even if you live for 100 years, it's just a while. Men of yesteryears, where are they? The man that sang that song, Orlando Owo, is resting with the Lord. So why must we take power as if it's something that we are going to carry to our grave? We are where we are to make others happy. We should use our platform well. As a king, I must make that people are happy, not necessarily giving them money by words of mouth. Orlando Owo, that's particular song our leaders should internalize all the time.
I want you now to talk about your greatest passion and your biggest project that you wish to bequeath to humanity, the Abolani College, Okela, Orogun. From the beginning till now.
Yes, that is, you know, I was a teacher for 10 years. And to the glory of God, very many of my students, I know very many of them are watching me. They are doing very well all over the world. How old was I when I started teaching? I was just 22, 23. I was just 22, 23 then in Oscars. But very many of them, they are doing very well today. When? Education. If we want to change Nigeria, all Nigerians must have access to education. Be the children of the poor, the children of the weak, they must have access to education. The government must plan for it. For our generation, those of us in the university system in the 70s, and even before, the state provided for our education. How much were we paying, Ife, those days? Ibadan Polytechnic, those days. Despite that we were in school, paying almost nothing, we were given students bursary, we were given student loan of 500 naira, a year, which was good money. And I'm not sure if we paid back. Go on, plan for today. And that is why it's important for us to invest more in human beings, human capital development, rather than the physical now. Thank God for COVID. I mean, we know that now health is wealth. We know that our doctors, our nurses are in far, 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 far important. Yes, I pray that we invest more in education, but I know that government alone cannot do it. The government alone cannot do it. That is why it is important for government and the private sector to now come together, not in terms of, yes, we are the senior partner. The two should work together for our future. Our future is too important. We waste a lot of money sending our kids abroad. We waste a lot of money going abroad for medicals. I'm in Okela now. I'm stuck, yeah. Bob D, Bashonu, you've been in Nigeria the last 6 weeks. You've never experienced that in 20 years. Even when you are struggling, even when you are a struggling journalist. So we know that home is home, that we have to invest in Nigeria. And the only way we can invest in Nigeria is education. Education for the good of our people. Education for service. What is the essence of our education when people are suffering? What? Why did we go to school? And you have poverty all around us. Lean on me when you are not strong. You leaned on someone to get to where you are, but I leaned on someone to get to where I am. You know, when we were going around in Ife those days, I mean, we reported. And probably that is why I'm facing education squalor, especially the children of the poor. Is in our interest, is an enlightened self-interest. If we fail to take care of the children of the poor, and they are massive now, they are in the majority, they are going to snuff lives off us. It's key, it's important. The government and the private sector and individuals must work hand in hand for the good of our future.
Yes, I wanted the story of our Bolani College. Can you see?
Wow.
Yes, so tell us how...
I must confess that.
How you started.
I went about 7 years ago. I was in Tanzania. Apart from my passion for humanity, 7 years ago, I was in Tanzania and I saw the hotel where I was in Arusha, Ngromoto. That environment is just like Okela Onogunya, rural. There's a 5-star hotel where you have people coming from all over the world. And very close to that, I saw this school. This school strictly for the Tanzania poor. Beautiful environment. And I had to interview these children. And their passion for Tanzania, their passion for doing more than Julius Nyerere in Walimu. Then I said, wow, we're in trouble in Nigeria. If you have these little children clamoring to be bigger than Nyerere, then it's going to be difficult for our own children, no matter how big we are, to compete with them in the foreseeable future. So I got home and I said, the ball rolling. You know, I'm not a rich man. In fact, I have a list of benefactors. I started to connect to my friends. And there, I went to a private secondary school where the consultant assisted me, to be specific. Babcock University High School. The principal there, Dr. Timothy Adetayo, and his group. We worked together for about 6 months. The blueprint was established. And up we go. My late brother may so rest in perfect peace. That was about the time that he left us. He didn't understand the concept. He was asking me, Kabis, what about this thing? I said, don't worry. I'm just going to do this thing. He said, how are you going to do it? Is it feasible? I said, you know, when you have a vision, it's a vision. Others may not share in that vision. Conducted the entrance examination, you must be rural, you must be indigent. And we started with the public and in my area, the old Osun of East, from Ikiru to Okuku to part of Kwara, my Igbomina people, then part of Ikiru, then all of us, because that the head boy since inception of that school is my son, Gabriel Eronsi, from Abraka, is a Niger Delta. And I tell these children that they must always celebrate diversity. I have my son, John Chigoze, from Ebonyi. I have Francis Okebe is Igede from Benue and Elizabeth. If you listen to their stories, you cry. People come, they'll cry, they shed tears. Because children must have access to education. The children of the poor. My father of blessed memory in the Laja Bolani family came from a poor background, if not because of his brothers, Tayo and Ibitoye, that sent him to school. He wouldn't have been who he was before he died. So why must we abandon the poor? We cannot afford to abandon the poor. So that is the concept. And to the glory of God, we are presenting 28 of them for WAEC and NECO this year. 28 of them start for JAM. And they did very well. They did very well. Because at least out of the 28, 27 of them are university material. And I keep saying, it's an enlightened self-interest. If people think that, is it feasible? Is it, what is the gain? What is, if the Nigerian society is better, if they can create wealth in the future, if they won't snuff out life out of our children, that is the gain. It's the society that we gain. I'm around to see the greatness of these children. Because they work so hard. And when people come to our school and tell me that Kabisi is this another Mayflower, it gladdens my heart. Yeah. May the good Lord continue to rest. Dr. Aishulari and Sherryland souls. Where we are going, I cannot divorce myself from my Christian background.
So I hear you. Even teach the students personally.
I do. I teach government and I teach them style, especially my girls. Because very many people think that those of us outside of Lagos, we are rural. Awarauke, you know? And you know, when I see my girls, they make me happy. If I tell any of them that sit like a lady, they know what I'm talking about. They sit upright, they sit right, stand. I take them out. I'm very busy. That is my ministry. Royalty, my own royalty is ministerial. And for us now, traditional rulers, that's the way I see it. We are no longer conquering territories. We are no longer selling people as slaves. The wars to be fought and won is against poverty, illiteracy. It's poverty, illiteracy, and to promote development. And a major institution for the development of our people is the traditional institution. I didn't know this until I became a king. I believe that in a Republican state, you don't need the king. But for who we are, we believe in our culture. We believe in our tradition. And we should use that culture and tradition for the betterment of our future. In a nutshell, that is all we are doing. And it's not quite different from what you are doing, Dele. It's not. You are creative. You are resourceful.
Thank you, sir.
They can't bottle you up. You've always been a restless soul, but determined. You know where you are going. You know what you can do. You know what you are capable of doing. Probably that was the reason why you said that. Immediately I told you that, hey, there's this sentiment about my becoming a king. I said, take it up. I know you. There are too many important things that we can do. I thank God for the platform. I thank God for the royal platform that I'm using to operate. And we should prepare our young ones for leadership. And there's a passage that I'm so fond of. For me, it is developmental. The book of Isaiah 58:12. And they that shall be of thee shall build the old, and they shall be called the repairer of the breach and the restorer of the parts to dwell in. Enough of being critics, like Theodore Roosevelt, like he said, let's have more of doers. there is poverty in the land. People are bitter. If we do not do something, we are playing with thunderstorm. We are playing with fire that may consume all of us. Let us reappraise. Let us think deep. Let us use our education for the good of our future.
Well, let's say, Amariba. On this note, I say a big thank you to Kabiyesi Obadedo Kwabolarin, the Aruyikeye, first of Okela Orogun, and then we are going to close. Kabiyesi, Oda Rosa, Kabiyesi.